Most famous predictor of spring's arrival, of course, is Pennsylvania's Punxsutawney Phil.
But famous doesn't necessarily mean accurate. And this morning, Phil made the 138th prediction on whether there will be six more weeks of winter.
But what this weather did not provide is a shadow or reason to hide. Glad tidings on this Groundhog Day. An early spring is on the way.
I love that not only is there a crowd and the cheering, but the way he turns the scroll over to see,
right.
See?
Yeah.
So this year, Phil did not see his shadow, meaning it could be an early spring this season.
It could be. We'll
Who
see.
Knows?
We hope so. But just how accurate is Dr. Phil, whatever you may want to call him here, Punxsutawney Phil, meteorologist Ethan Rosuck joining us now to break down his predictions over the years. Hey, Ethan.
Hey, guys. You know, I spent a lot of time, more time than I'll admit here, to go through the data to kind of compare where Punxsutawney Phil's predictions have been when it comes to our weather here in central Indiana. It's definitely an interesting way to go about things, but the numbers aren't that surprising. Happy Groundhog Day indeed. He did see his shadow for only the 20th time since officially it started over in Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania. 1887 was the first time the Groundhog Ceremony occurred there, and he did see his early spring, 20th time today, and I found out that the reason why Groundhog Day is held on February 2nd. It's because today is the halfway point between the winter solstice and the spring equinox, which is the official start of winter and then the official start of spring. We are at the halfway point there right now. That's actually kind of interesting. And he's seen his shadow 107 times, 84% of the years since 1887, and including today, the 20th time, which is around 16%. Of years. Now, here's what I did for us here in central Indiana. I computed the average temperature for 6 weeks' time from today, February 2nd, through March 15th. That's 6 weeks. And take that average temperature from 1887 through last year, and I got 33.6 degrees for an average temperature. Now, for example, if he did see his shadow like he did in 2014, and the temperature was below that, this is how also NOAA does their predictions comparing with Punxsutawney Phil. He saw his shadow and the temperature was below the average, aka winter stuck around. He was correct in 2014, 2015. But then he didn't see his shadow in 2016, and he was also right that year. You can see what I mean here. About half the time, a little over that, he was correct over the last decade. But going back to 1887 in general, he's been wrong 66 years for Indy's weather pattern, accounting for 52% of the years, correct 61 years, and then for the entire United States as a whole, over the last decade, he was 30% correct. And then since 1887, he was correct 39% of the time. And yes, all for a groundhog, all those numbers, Michelle.